Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Yesterday, SpaceX successfully launched their first Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Thuraya 4 NGS.
Go Falcon, go Thuraya.
The booster which launched this mission, B1073, then landed successfully for the 20th time on the drone ship, a shortfall of gravitas.
Stage 1 landing confirmed.
SpaceX have a handful of launches scheduled for next week. The first of these, the Starlink 671 mission, is currently scheduled for tomorrow, Monday 6 at 5:21 PM UTC or 12:21 PM EST. A day later and we should see another Starlink mission launch. The Starlink 1211 mission is currently scheduled for Tuesday 7th at 3:51 PM UTC or 10:51 AM EST. A few days after that and we should see a couple more Falcon launches. The first of these, the NROL 153 mission, is currently scheduled for Friday 10th at 3:19 AM UTC or Thursday 9th at 10:19 PM EST. Then around 12 hours later and we should see yet another Starlink mission launch. The Starlink 1212 mission is currently scheduled for Friday 12th at 3:27 PM UTC or 10:27 AM EST. Heading to Boca Chica, the orbital launch mount scaffolding has started being disassembled. Work has also been continuing on the chopsticks as we get closer to Flight 7. Work continues on the orbital pad B chopstick components. Work has also been continuing on the orbital launch mount for pad B at Starbase. Some rather bizarre news was posted about SpaceX's Starbase. It says the Federal Bureau of Investigation is inquiring about threats made against SpaceX's Starbase facility near Boca Chica Beach in Brownsville. According to the Bureau, several individuals have threatened to blow up a Starship rocket near the facility. With Starship Flight 7 coming up very soon, hopefully on Friday 10th, SpaceX posted some information in a thread. Their first post says Starship 6 flight test aimed to push the vehicle to its limits as we iterate towards a rapidly reusable rocket. Up next, a new ship, new year, and new limits. In this thread, they also posted information about improvements to the flaps and heat shield. They said the vehicle's forward flaps have been reduced in size and shifted towards the vehicle tip and away from the heat shield, significantly reducing their exposure to re-entry heating while simplifying the underlying mechanisms and protective tiling. The ship's heat shield will also use the latest generation tiles and includes a backup layer to protect from missing or damaged tiles. There was also some information posted on SpaceX's website about payload simulators for Starship Flight 7. It says, while in space, Starship will deploy 10 Starlink simulators similar in size and weight to next-generation Starlink satellites as the first exercise of a satellite deploy mission. The Starlink simulators will be on the same suborbital trajectory as Starship, with splashdown targeted in the Indian Ocean. Somebody noted something interesting and Musk responded confirming it's correct. They said SpaceX is apparently planning to reuse the 314 Raptor engine. It previously flew on Booster 12 during Flight 5 and is expected to be used again on Booster 14 for Flight 7. Musk responded with, "Good observation." As SpaceX prepare for Starship Flight 7, Booster 14 was lifted onto the orbital launch mount. SpaceX did a bit of grid fin testing with Booster 14. Some work was seen going on with Booster 14's flight termination system, indicating possible installation. As always, I have to say thanks to both Mary, otherwise known as Boca Chica Gal, and Jack Beyer for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.